All right, so moving on from our last video, we're working on the sequence from the straight punches where we're inserting, we call it a sector, where we're sort of creating, in a way, a predictable punch. It's not guaranteed, but this is what some of the Kali masters were really good at with the weapon and without. So in this instance, what we were looking at is off that straight punch, and we did some drills earlier, you should check them out in the other video of working on timing. There's other drills you can add, but we're just gonna do it statically right now. I go one, and then we carry this across and we hit the throat, and we were looking at this little movement here where we're ripping through the bicep or any part of this inside of the arm, but we're targeting the bicep, trapping down and then hammering or hacking with this right hand and then going into a follow-up. It's very common in Panatukan for them to switch their base and hit while they off-balance the guy. Okay, but let's look at some other options here. So from this one here, okay, when I'm inside and I rip this through, I'm gonna hit, but now I'm gonna change my left hand position, right? So while he's dealing with this, he's sort of getting distracted. I can put my forearm, my right forearm, I'm gonna roll this. I'm gonna keep his elbow elevated. I'm gonna step back and I'm gonna roll onto that part of his arm there. We call it trigger point. And then I'll just lift out again, here like this, and I can just go right into the striking again, right? So if you do it from this angle, right? So I'm doing that same entry. One, two, I'm hitting the throat again. I'm mousing the bicep, I'm hitting, but you see how I changed my hand position here. So it's important I'm doing that. That distracts him, or maybe I gel the body, I get a strike here, and I'm going back to here, right in the middle of the arm, and I'm rolling this, right? I keep the elbow elevated as much as I can. I step this foot back. Right? And I drop his base and then I lift up again here, right? And again, you can go into anything you want from that point, right? We tend to just at first start it and strike it, okay? So number two option from here. Now, I like this from maybe a palm strike instead of a throat thrust. Same motion, same position, but look where my hand goes. Now it's gonna collapse the elbow and bring it to me. Very similar mechanics as we were doing earlier. You see how I was bringing his base? Now look, I can crank that shoulder and get a shot here, or I can continue to drop him down to the ground, or I can do a little do-si-do thing there, a little back and forth with my forearm. So one more time. I'm staying on the inside now of his arm. So we got one, two, look at this, three, push. Get like that, okay? So first one, we went through. We hit, we rolled this, and then went back out, okay? Second one, we're staying inside, but we're collapsing that elbow, right? And using that as a way to manipulate the shoulder. We can use it as a way to take them down, right? Or again, just a quick pulse and forearm out, all right? So there's two more variations you can add to this entry, okay? And then the last one we'll do, we'll throw in a couple more, and then we're gonna do some takedowns. Jordo's gonna throw some of his favorite stuff in there. So yeah, man, look out. Look out. See you next time.